Okay, we discussed about different types of dimension tables and then different types of fact tables, right? Okay. And then now all these dimension and fact tables, like why we require all these dimension and fact tables? Like to form the data warehouse, right? To form data warehouse, we require dimension tables and fact tables. And for that, one second. For this star schema, okay, star schema and snowflake schema, generally one fact table surrounded by dimension tables, right?
Yes.
Surrounded by dimension tables. So this is a structure, right? Generally, we will call it as a structure for the data warehousing. And suppose, for example, if you want to construct a home, so before that you will like design a plan, right? We should have some plan. So how many rooms should be there, which type of house we need to construct, like duplex or apartment or individual house, okay, like that. So the same thing here also, we need structure before creating a data warehouse. So how we need to decide, who will decide this, who will decide this structure? So here architects will be there. So generally architects, so like any language before starting the project, architects will involve the high level. So they will give complete design, right? They will give the complete design of project or any platform. So what they will do here, the same thing, data warehousing also we will have a architects. So data warehousing architects, what they will do, they will like they will build the did you heard about like dimension modeling anywhere or data modeling?
Yes, I've heard.
Do you know what it mean by that?
Data modeling techniques means
forming
different type of star schema or snowflake schema.
Okay, fine. Okay, data modeling techniques are here, we have dimension modeling. We will call it as a dimension modeling. Dimension modeling means, so before constructing a data warehouse, we need one structure, right? We need one structure. So this structure, how they will decide with the form of dimension, we will call it as a dimension modeling for data warehousing. Generally, like data modeling means like when they are creating a database, they will use data modeling techniques to like how many tables is required, which table you need, how much space, and then what all the columns required in that particular table, what is the relation between the one table to another table, dependency tables, all these things. That is data modeling technique. Here the same thing, dimension modeling techniques we have for creating, to create data warehouse. To create data warehouse, we will follow dimension modeling. Here in dimension modeling, who will involve means architects will involve in dimension modeling. Now here we have three approaches. One, first one is conceptual modeling. First one is conceptual modeling, and the other one is logical modeling, and another one is physical modeling. Now they will divide these things, this dimension modeling, into three types: conceptual modeling, logical modeling, physical modeling. Regularly, if you observe anything, generally if you are starting any business, if you are starting anything, so we will do all these things without our notification. We will follow all these steps generally. Suppose for example, Nazma, now you are planning for a movie this weekend.
Okay.
Now tell me the things, what all the things will come into your mind first?
buying a ticket, booking a ticket.
Okay. Good. And then? Which movie, right?
Yes, sir, which movie? Okay.
Where we have to go, right? So, and then? With whom, right? With whom we have to go, right? So, with the friends or with family, with colleagues. Okay. And then, first we will decide which movie we have to go, right? Which movie, where we have to go, with whom we have to go. And then, any other things is coming into your mind?
No, sir.
Generally, regularly. How we have to go, right?
Okay.
How we have to go. We have to use public transport or we have to use our own vehicles.
Vehicle, okay.
Right? And then? And at what time we have to go?
Okay.
Right? At what time? These things, generally, these things we will not sit separately and we will not plan all these things, right? So, why?
Yeah.
Because we are habituated for all these things regularly. So, if you think one thing, if you want to, we are planning for go, we have to go to for this movie this weekend. Okay. Regularly, all these things will be automatically will come into our mind, right? So, which movie,
yes, sir,
where we have to go, which theater we have to go, with whom we have to go, and then how we have to go, and then at what time, what is our convenient time. We will first we will decide all these things, right? First we will decide all these things. After that, what we will do once we have decided, okay, like suppose colleagues or family members, four members we are going, you have decided, and this particular movie we have to go, you have decided, and then this particular, at this particular time we have to go, at this particular show we have to go, you have decided, and then what you will do, you will book the tickets, right? You will book the tickets, you will book the tickets. Okay, once you book the tickets, what you will do,
will pay.
Yes, payment, we will do the payment in online or anything. And then we will collect the tickets.
Tickets, yeah.
Okay. And then what you will do after that? Everything is ready. The day comes. We will move,
so
right?
How?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Physically, we will start. Start. Up to now, here. So, we did not involve physically. So, these things in the mind, in our mind, right?
Okay.
First thing is in our mind. Second thing, it's logically. So, it means we are not present there, but we are doing something, right?
Okay, yeah.
We are not physically there, but we are doing something. Like we have booked the ticket, we received the tickets in online, we did the payment in online and we received the tickets to our mail or mobile, right? So,
yes,
and then if the day comes, then only we will start physically, right? Until unless we will not start physically. Now, all these things, first one, we can call it as a conceptual modeling. Conceptual modeling. Second one, physical, sorry, logical modeling.
Logical.
Second one is logical modeling.
Logical.
And third one, physical model, physical modeling. So, same thing, if we applicable, if we applicable, if we applicable, sorry, apply these particular things to the data warehousing, okay, in conceptual modeling we will decide like what is will be the lowest level granularities, what all the attributes we required, what all the columns we required. So all these things we will decide. Suppose if you want to analyze something, so we need some columns, right? Some key performance indicators, right?
Yes, sir.
If you want to analyze something, we need some key performance
KPI
indicators. Then only we can decide. So here in conceptual modeling, in the data warehousing or dimension modeling, we will decide what all the columns is required. So we will decide the business requirement first. They will decide what is our business requirement. So once the business requirement is clear, so there we have decided we need to go to this particular movie. That is our requirement, right? So here the business requirement, we need to know the business requirement, and then we need to know the what all the attributes is required. So there we have decided which movie we have to go, and then we have decided with whom we have to go and at what time we have to go, right? The same thing here also, we need to understand the business requirement first. Once the business requirement is clear, then we have to start what all the columns is required. It means what all the key performance indicators required for that particular table. So what all the columns is required to analyze the business. Okay, they will identify those things. So he in above thing, above example, we will identify with whom we need to go, right? The same thing here in conceptual modeling in the data warehousing, we will identify what all the columns is required to analyze the business. Those columns we will put in the data warehouse. Those columns they will decide. So once everything is decided, business requirement is clear, and then this attributes, okay, and key performance indicators, okay, those things is clear, okay, then they will come to fact tables. So we need to move to the logical modeling. In the logical modeling, they will decide how many fact tables and how many dimension tables is required. How many fact tables we required, and then for each and every fact table, how many dimensions is required.
Okay.
So they will decide these things. So once the facts and dimensions is done,
decided.
Fact tables is dimension tables is ready. So we are not doing anything up to now. We are doing like logically and concept wise only. So it's in the only papers or in minds. That's it, right? So it's not existed anywhere physically. So once the facts and dimensions is decided, then we need a relationship between the fact and dimension, right? For each and every fact, how many dimensions is required? So for this particular dimension, what will be the primary key? And for this particular fact table, what will be the foreign key from that particular dimension table? In that fact table, what all the things, what all the columns are the key performance indicators? And then what is the primary key in the fact table? Those things they have to decide in the logical modeling.
Logical modeling.
Logical modeling. Once everything is done, then they will move to the physical modeling. In the physical modeling, just here we will start, right? Physically, we will move to movie. Here also the same thing. Physically, they will create up to now. It's in the papers or in mind, but here what they will do, they will create the tables, they will create fact tables and dimension tables with the columns, with the keys, like primary keys and foreign keys in the database level. In the database level, they will create that particular tables, facts and dimension tables.
Okay,
this one is called as a physical modeling. So now you are clear. So if you take any example, if you are, suppose if you want to construct a home, so what all the things you will decide first? You
first
are planning
place,
to construct
land.
A home. Yes, first we required land, right? So first we required a land. So after that land is ready, you are planning to construct a home, then we need a plan, right? We need a house plan, right? So what all the things we required? So how many floors we need to construct, right? Each and every floor, how many houses should be there, right? So each and every house, how many rooms should be there, how many bedrooms should be there, how many halls should be, it means it's a 2 BHK or 3 BHK house, right?
Okay.
So all these are the requirements, right? All this will be in the plan. All this will be in the plan.
Yeah.
Once you have decided these many floors, these many houses, the each and every house, these many bedrooms and parking place and everything. Okay, everything you have decided. So plan is ready. Then what you will do?
Get the raw material to construct.
Yes, exactly. You have to like purchase the raw material, right? You have to purchase the raw material like iron, cement, like bricks, everything, right? Once everything is done, then only you will start constructing the home, right? Constructing the house or apartment, anything. So before that, we will plan, and then logically it should be ready to build, right? Ready to build. Then only we will move. Then only we will start constructing. So this process, if you take any business, okay, they will regularly they will follow these approaches, right? Conceptual, logical, and then
physical.
Okay, so these things, okay, these things will be taken care by the architects, data warehousing architects. Okay, no need to bother about all these things. Okay, so for the better understanding, I am explaining these things. This is the process. Okay,
fine.
Now we will discuss one thing. Up to now, we discussed like data warehousing, right? So data warehousing, OLAP, online analytical processing. Do you know what it means by the OLAP? OLAP means online analytical processing. So for the analyzing the business, we need OLAP systems. The same thing up to now, whatever we're discussing, all are online analytical processing. So with the help of reporting tools, tools, they will analyze the business. So ETL, with the help of ETL tool, what we will do? We will load the data into the data warehouse. That's it, right?
Yes. Yeah.
With the help of OLAP tools or reporting tools, they will analyze the business. Okay. And then one more process, the OLTP.
Online transaction processing. Yes.
What it mean by that, online transactional processing?
Whatever transactions we do online, this thing records it.
Good, very good. Very good. Online transactional processing. So this OLAP, analytical processing, up to now regular businesses, regular any sales business or anything. Okay, any sales like any domain, we can take a healthcare domain, sales domain, we can call it as the example for the OLAP systems. And OLTP systems, online transactional processing, best examples we can
train ticket booking, online shopping,
train ticket booking, or any like Amazon, like
bank transactions,
ATM transactions, all this will be OLTP systems, online transactional processing. Here one important thing is ODS, operational data stores. Here we have data warehouse, here we have data warehouse, but here we have ODS, operational data stores. Why we require ODS system for the OLTP? Why we required ODS system?
Because it will store the current processing data.
Yes, exactly. The transactions data, they will store all these transactions data into the ODS system. ODS means like integrated view of operational data, operational transactions information, integrated view of operational systems. We can call it as a operational system. So ODS means operational
data store,
data operational data store, ODS. So it means it's an integrated view of all OLTP systems in simple form, integrated view of all OLTP systems. Why we required this operational data store? So, one second. So, from this operational data store, OLTP systems, OLTP systems to ODS, ODS to ODS to they will load into data warehouse. Why we require this ODS in middle of OLTP systems? We can directly process whatever the data is there. This is one source system, right? OLTP. So,
yes.
So we can load directly to the data warehouse. So in why we require operational data store here? Any idea, Asma?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Here, suppose when you are doing online transactions, the volume of data, how it will, like, it will come?
Large in bulk.
Yes. It's a large volume, right? Huge volume.
Yes,
so data will be very vast. Suppose each and every minute the transactions will be more. So many transactions we can't imagine, right? Suppose any online transactions, if you are doing any shopping in online, if you are doing, if you are suppose take an example of train booking, how many passengers will book the ticket? Each and every minute, each and every second, some transactions will be going on, right? So many persons will book the ticket, so many persons will cancel the ticket, so many things will be there, right? Suppose, for example, okay. Generally, if you observe or not, if you go for the ATM to withdraw some amount, okay, you withdraw some $100 or $200 something, okay, from the ATM, but you did not receive that amount from the ATM, but amount is debited from your account. Anytime it happened to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then what you will do?
Contact the bank.
Yes, we will contact the bank. What they will tell? They will take
yeah.
that particular receipt ID, ATM ID, transaction date, and then your account number and everything, right? And then
yes,
they will tell us within 7 working days or within 15 working days, we will reprocess the amount to you, right?
Yes,
so
sir.
Immediately they can process the amount to us, right? Why they require these many days? So why they are keeping our money with them these many days? Here, the concept in this is generally, okay, OLTP systems, so each and every ATM, for example, each and every ATM is one OLTP system. So each and every ATM is a one source system here. The end of the day, what they will do is they will load all the transactions to the ODS system, all the information to ODS. So they will
all
not,
similar kind of data is stored into one ODS.
Yes, one ODS system. So it's a operational data store. So all this operational transactional data, they are loading into ODS system. Here in the ODS, they will keep that information for like 6 to 1 year, 6 months, maximum 6 months to 9 months or 6 months to 1 year. So after that, okay, if you want that information, if you want to maintain the history, we need a history, right? If you want to analyze the business, we need history. In the ODS system, they can't maintain more than 6 months to 1 year.
Okay.
More than 6 months. So what they will do after the 6 months, 6 months old data, they will load into data warehouse. They will load those data into data warehouse. Why they will keep those data, 6 months or 1 year data into ODS system means these are the transactional business. So transactional data, transactions will be happen on this. Suppose like example, like we discussed, what are the example we discussed? You withdraw the amount, but amount did not came to you, right? So we did not received any amount, but amount debited from your account. So here what they will do, they will load all the data into the ODS system. What they have to do means they will go and check all the transaction in ODS system. They will check all the transaction in ODS system. If the ODS system, that particular, it's also a small size of data warehouse, right? So all the related information will be there. So all the source systems information will be there. So they will take the report from that particular ODS system. At that particular time, particular ATM, is there any issue is there? They will have a look, right? At that particular transaction, amount received from, sorry, amount received to the customer or not, they will check, right? If it is not received, what they will do? They will reprocess the amount to your account to check that process. So generally what they will do, from the ATM systems to ODS, it takes time, right? Generally, sometimes they will load each and every end of the day, they will load all the data to ODS system. Otherwise, like 2 days once, 3 days once, like weekend, weekly once, they will load the data into ODS system. From to take the reports, where they have to go? They have to go to the ODS system, right? ODS systems. These kind of adjustments, remember this, adjustments are negations.
Okay.
In real time, we will call these kind of transactions adjustments or negations. Some organizations, they will call it as a carry forwards. Okay. What we are doing here, the transaction is, it's a, like this particular transaction, what we are doing here, we are doing some negations. We are doing some transactions on particular data, right? Whatever the transaction is happened previously, again we are doing some transactions. Particular transaction, we are doing some adjustments to that particular thing. Then what they will do, they will revert back that amount from this ODS system. So if we don't have this ODS system, operational data store, for example, okay, assume that if you don't have ODS system, we will directly load the data from OLTP system to data warehouse. OLTP to data warehouse. If you load that particular data into data warehouse, if you have any adjustments or any negations, any corrections you have to do, then is it possible to do it from data warehouse? No, right? Why? Because so we can't do any operations on the data warehouse.
It's
just only read-only purpose. So to do these type of operations, to do these type of corrections, we need ODS system. Here also they will maintain only 6 months to 1 year of data. So now you understand, right? Why we require ODS system? How we will, what is the process of OLTP systems to, how they will analyze the business from the OLTP system. For example, the best example, regularly we will go for shopping, right?
Yeah.
Right? If you go for shopping, if you purchase some $1,000 or $2,000, okay, you purchase, they will give some $200 coupons, okay? What they will tell, gift coupons, they will give it to you. Okay.
Yeah.
This particular $200 amount, it is valid for the next billing amount, right? Not this billing amount. It's valid for next bill cycle. If you purchase something in the next bill, then will be redeemed, right?
Yeah.
So at the same time, the coupon code will be valid till 6 months only, right? Or till 6 months or 4 months, generally. After 4 months, after validity period, after validity expired, after 4 months or 6 months validity expired, okay, you did not remember that particular thing, and then one day, one final day, you found that ticket somewhere, you found that coupon somewhere, and then you went to the particular mall or shopping mall, and then you ask that particular like billing salesperson or billing accountant, okay, so I want to redeem that particular $200 coupon in this purchase. What they will tell?
They will tell this is not valid.
Yes, why it is not valid? Already you have purchased, okay, at the same time your name, your ID will be there, your invoice ID will be there, how much amount you have purchased previously, it will be there with them, right? Everything will be there with them, right? At the same time this coupons code will be there, and then coupons, gift coupons amount also will be there. But why it is not possible to redeem? So if you request them also, they will tell that the support system, it will not support the data, that particular invoice, for your invoice or your ID on particular your, you, if you purchase something, you will have one invoice ID, right? Transaction ID, it means nothing but transaction ID. They will tell that for this particular transaction ID, this in our system, that particular transaction ID, it's not there, it's already expired, it's deleted from our machine, right? It's deleted from our storage. So why it's deleted? What is happening backend means they will load that particular transactions, your invoice ID, and then your account, sorry, you, how much you have purchased, and what is the discount amount or coupon discount amount, everything will be stored in the ODS system, right? In the ODS system, up to how many months the data will be there? Up to 6 months only, right? So if you go after 6 months, what they will do? They will load all the previous data into data warehouse, right? All the previous data into data warehouse. So in the ODS system, data will not be there. So they are unable to do the corrections or adjustments. So if that particular invoice ID, it's not there in their system, they will not do anything, right? So that is the reason behind that. Okay, they will not accept that redeemed coupons. Okay, so now you understood, right, why we required ODS system. So ODS means operational data store. If you are doing any transactional kind of business, generally if you purchase anything in online, generally if you ordered some shoes in online, okay, or any site like Amazon or Flipkart, anything, if you order something, okay, once it received to you, okay, the chances is there to like you will return it back to them, right? Chances is there, right? So if you return it back, what they will do? They will do the again the corrections, right? So at that particular ID, the same ID will be there, they will take your same ID, and then particular your account, they will revert it back a amount. So immediately they will not revert, they will take at least 1 or 2 days, right? They will take at least 1 or 2 days. So these kind of transactions, these kind of corrections and adjustments, they will, with the help of ODS systems, they will do that. Now you understood the difference between the date ODS and data warehouse, right?
Yes, sir.
Now what's the difference between ODS and data warehouse, Asma?
Operational data store has a similar kind of current data.
Okay, good.
Where we can make corrections.
Okay. Transactions. Can we can do the transactions here, right? In the ODS system, and we can do the transactions. Good. Okay. In the data warehouse, it's not possible to do the transactions, right? And then at the same time, in the ODS, we can't maintain history, right?
Yes.
So only it will maintain like 6 months to 1 year of data only. But in data warehouse, we will maintain history, right? We'll maintain the history. The main difference, this is the main difference. Transactional purpose, ODS. Data warehouse is read-only purpose. Yes. Here we can maintain history. In ODS, we can't maintain history. in the data warehouse we can do the analysis, but in ODS we can't do the complete analysis, right? We can't take the decisions on particular thing. Now you are clear, right? What is the difference between ODS and data warehouse?
Yes.
Now one more thing. Slowly changing dimensions. One more concept is there, that is slowly
changing dimensions.
So you heard that this slowly changing dimensions anywhere?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. We'll discuss. Now, slowly changing dimensions means the name itself, it says the dimension table. When we are loading the data into the dimension table, suppose for example, if you have any, take example of any organizations, we will have the like employee table will be there, right? Employees will be there, right?
Yes.
So for these employees, how frequently they will give the increment to their employees? Max
yearly
once, right? Or
yeah,
some organizations 6 months once. That's it, right?
Half yearly
one or yearly ones. So the data in that particular employee table, is the data is changing frequently or it's changing slowly?
It's changing slowly.
It's changing slowly, right? So slowly changing dimension means it describes the how the changes is going on in the dimension table. How the changes is capturing into the dimension tables, how we are capturing the changes into dimension tables. Basically, these are three types: SCD 1, slowly changing dimension 2, and then SCD 3. 1 and 2 and 3. Slowly changing dimension 1 means it will maintain present, only present data. Only
okay, there will be no history here.
Yes, we will maintain only present data. In SCD2, complete history. In SCD3, present and previous. Present and previous data. It means partial history. Partial history. SCD2, slowly changing dimension 2, it means it will maintain that particular dimension table, it should maintain complete history. Complete history. SCD1 means it should maintain present data. SCD3 means it will maintain present and previous information only. Suppose, for example, I will give the example, then you will be more clear on this. Suppose if you get any offer from any bank, any banking company,
okay,
what they will ask before releasing the offer, what they will ask you? They will ask all the documents from you, right?
Yes, sir.
All the required document, all your previous experience, all your education certificates, everything, right? So why they required, they have to do the background check,
background,
right? Background verification check. So BGC, background check. So for this, what they required, suppose your name, sorry, name, company, year, address, right? So they required everything. Suppose your name, anything. So this is the employee name, and then company where he is working. Suppose for example XYZ, and year 2010. What is the address? Particular address. What is that particular address? In the 2010, where that particular person is staying at that particular period, right? So for example, is staying in the time he is staying in US, for example, at the same person, and then he changed that company to anything. okay, in 2013. Okay, he moved to UK. Address also required, right? UK
yeah.
address. Address here, US address. They required US address. And then the same person, now observe here, same person moved to some other company in 2015. He moved to Canada. So what they required? Canada complete address, right? So here what they are verifying, what they required? They required complete address and then company name and which year he, for that particular person work over there. So same mm-hmm. thing, each and everything they required, right?
Yeah.
So they required all the information, complete history they required, complete history of that particular employee. So where he worked, so where he stayed, the address mm-hmm. and then which year and then which company, everything, each and every information they required. It means complete history information they required here, right? So without yes, this sir. It's not possible to do the background check, right?
Mm-hmm.
Without this, it's not possible to do complete background check. If they miss this one, if they don't have this information, what they will do? They will request you, right? So they will ask yeah. you to provide that particular information. In between in between 2013 to 2015, where you are, right? They will ask you
mm-hmm.
in which company you have worked. So all this information we require to verify background check, to do the background check. So must and should we need to provide all this information. So if these kind of information we are maintaining, then we can call it as a SCD2. These kind of information, complete history we are maintaining here, right?
Yeah.
See,
okay.
Here address, we are not changing frequently.
Yeah.
So we will not change the address frequently here, right? So
mm-hmm.
2 years once, 3 years once we are changing. So
yeah.
whenever the data changes in the source system, how we are capturing the data into the dimension tables? Here we are maintaining complete history into the dimension tables. So we can call this as a SCD2 type dimension, SCD2, complete
okay.
history. So on the same example, when we need only present data, any example for this, Asma? Only mm-hmm. present. Suppose if you order anything in online, they will ask your communication address, right?
Yes, sir.
So they need only one address. So they will
yeah.
not bother about where you have stayed previous year,
mm-hmm.
where you have stayed before year, right? So they
yeah.
don't want to bother about your previous address. What they required is only your communication address to deliver that particular product. So if they want these kind of information, at that particular time, what you will do? You will give only this information only, right? You will give only this information. It means whenever the data is, whenever the you are changing the address, they will maintain only your present address only. They will maintain only your present
address. Present address.
That's it. It means only present data. Only
yes.
present data. Then we will call it as the SCD1. Now SCD2. SCD2. Any example of SCD2, Asma? Okay, same thing. If you apply any credit card or if you apply for any passport or anything, okay. If you are, when you are filling the form, okay. In one address box, they will separately one, they have given one like separate column boxes, right? Like for if you are planning to shift your house or if you are planning to shift your home within 1 or 2 weeks, please mention
Yes.
that particular address, right?
Yes, sir.
They required this kind of situations, they required both the addresses, right? So communication address, your future address. So where you are going, right? So they required, suppose if it is delayed for 1 or 2 weeks, so they will first send it to your communication address, present address. If you are not there, what they will do? They will return, they will give it back to the another address, right? They will deliver it to the another address, like communication address and then permanent address. Suppose you will give communication address at the same time permanent address also, right? So if
yes,
you are
sir.
Not there in communication address, then what they will do? They will send it to your
permanent address.
Permanent address. Here what we are maintaining, we are maintaining both the things, right? So present data and immediate previous information. Present information and immediate previous information. Here what we are maintaining, we are not maintaining complete history, we are maintaining partial history only.
Partial history, okay.
Right, we are maintaining partial history. SCD means slowly changing dimension. Whenever the data is changing slowly in the dimension tables or the source systems, how the data is capturing to the dimension tables is called as a SCD, slowly changing dimensions.
Dimension.
When we are like practicing like informatica stuff, we will, it will come, everything will come, SCD1, SCD2, how we have to maintain slowly changing dimensions. Okay,
okay.
We will discuss these things in depth. Okay, now SCD1 means only present data. Remember, the SCD1 means only present information. SCD2 means complete history.
Complete history.
3 means present
partial
and
history.
Previous. Present and previous. It means partial. Right?
Yes,
it means partial history. So, okay. Fine. Good. Now. And Asma, I shared some documents to you and with you and Neha, right?
Yes, sir.
Did you get a chance to go through the documents?
Yes, sir.
Okay, do you have any doubts in that?
No, sir. No doubts.
Okay, fine, good. All those things are like data warehousing.
Warehousing.
Yes,
yes, sir.
Data warehousing, basic stuff. Okay, just one more time, like brush up all those things, and
okay.
Tomorrow onwards we will jump into Informatica.
Okay,
okay.
Sir.
Tomorrow we will jump into Informatica stuff. Okay, and tomorrow we will I will explain what all the components will be there in Informatica and what we will do with the Informatica tool, all those things. Okay, and
okay.
Then once the meanwhile, could you please you and Neha, could you please ask the organizers to install the software in your machines?
Okay. Okay, sir.
Could you please send a mail to them?
Okay. Okay,
they
sir.
Will install the software. Like after installation, we will start like practicals. Okay, in Informatica.
Okay.
Okay. Any doubts in this class, Asma?
No, sir. No doubts. I am clear.
Okay. Fine. Good. If I am little bit fast or like you are able to follow me, right?
This is fine with me, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Good. Okay, fine, Asma. Thank you. We'll meet tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, fine. Yeah. Bye.
Bye.
I'm disconnecting now.
Yes, sir.